सी अकॉर्डिंग टू सिक्स्थ सम आई मीन जो हम लोगों ने अभी स्टार्ट किया था दिस वन दिस इज द क्वेश्चन सो दीज आर द केसेस ओके लेट्स सी वन बाय वन इनकम फ्रॉम हाउस प्रॉपर्टी इन इंग्लैंड व्हिच वाज डिपॉजिटेड इन बैंक इन इंग्लैंड हाउस प्रॉपर्टी
सिक्स्थ कंडीशन
यस सिक्स इट इज सिक्स्थ केस हाउस प्रॉपर्टी
मैम
वाज इन इंग्लैंड डिपॉजिटेड इन द बैंक ऑफ इंग्लैंड सो we have got nothing to do with India, therefore only one category.
मैम
Yes.
मैम ओ 80,000 रिमिटेड इन इंडिया मतलब मैम
Which point is this, beta?
मैम उसमें लिखा है ना फर्स्ट
नहीं which
क्वेश्चन में
point?
लिखा है और फर्स्ट ए पॉइंट फर्स्ट वाली
Remitted means लाया गया
तो फिर मैम उसका
to
कोई नहीं
India.
दिखाया जाएगा कि सबको टैक्सेबल है
देखो ब्रॉड टू इंडिया जो बोला है ना वो पीछे बोला है कंफ्यूज करने के लिए आगे वाली पॉइंट क्या बोली है वो ध्यान दो आप मेन सेंटेंस क्या है आपका इनकम फ्रॉम हाउस प्रॉपर्टी इन इंग्लैंड व्हिच वाज डिपॉजिटेड इन बैंक ऑफ इंग्लैंड दैट्स इट ये जो पीछे दिया हुआ है ना 80,000 रेमिटेड टू इंडिया इट इज नॉट टैक्सेबल इट इज
उसको
नॉट टू
देखना ही
बी
नहीं है।
हाँ
2 लाख okay, हाँ फिर मेरा राइट है।
इज टैक्सेबल इन ओनली वन कैटेगरी इनकम फ्रॉम बिजनेस इन पाकिस्तान कंट्रोल्ड फ्रॉम इंडिया दे हैव सेड 30,000 इज रिसीव्ड इन इंडिया एंड रेस्ट ऑफ द अमाउंट बिकॉज नहीं बोला है बिकॉज नथिंग हैज बीन डिस्क्लोज्ड वी हैव टू अज्यूम रिसीव्ड इन पाकिस्तान सो यू हैव टू डिवाइड द सिचुएशन इनटू टू डिफरेंट पार्ट्स फर्स्ट यू हैव टू राइट इनकम फ्रॉम बिजनेस इन पाकिस्तान कंट्रोल्ड फ्रॉम इंडिया अंडर दैट यू हैव टू डिवाइड इट इनटू टू डिफरेंट पार्ट्स रिसीव्ड इन इंडिया Now, wherever it is received in India, taxable in all cases. Is your answer correct?
Yes, ma'am.
And received in
Yes, ma'am.
Pakistan. Now you have to see received in Pakistan. For that, you need to read the sentence. Income from business in Pakistan controlled from India received in Pakistan. Read out the full sentence. So it is controlled
fifth,
from India.
Fifth वाला आ जाएगा
Fifth
ma'am.
case means two categories. Is everybody okay with it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. थर्ड इनकम फ्रॉम सेल ऑफ हाउस प्रॉपर्टी इन राजस्थान
राजस्थान कम अंडर इंडिया ना
इंडिया वेरी गुड इट इज
इसलिए
रिसीव्ड इन
तीनों
इंडिया इट इज अक्रूड फ्रॉम इंडिया एवरीथिंग इन इंडिया सो इट इज ऑल थ्री कैटेगरीज गिफ्ट गिफ्ट्स आर नॉट टैक्सेबल
टैक्स फ्री
यस व्हाट इज द अमाउंट ऑफ गिफ्ट 40,000 व्हिच इज बिलो 50 सो इट इज टैक्स फ्री रॉयल्टी रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट ऑफ
इनकम
इंडिया It is accrued from India. Received anywhere? No. Received anywhere in the world. But it is accrued from government of India. That means from India. Therefore, all three categories. Is it clear up to E point?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yeah.
Interest from a non-resident. Now, I am getting...
ये बारा नहीं समझाता
मैं. I will tell you. If suppose you are a non-resident, you are living in US. You are residing in US. I am living in India. I have provided you a loan. I am giving you a loan amount, maybe rupees 1 lakh. Now, I have told you that you have to pay me interest. So, I am getting interest of 10%. 1 lakh ka 10% is 10,000. So, on the basis of the amount of loan, you are giving me the interest. Okay, I live in India. Okay, now that amount of interest has been used. That amount of interest which I received from a non-resident, that is you, I'm using this amount of interest for my business. Okay, where is the business? In India. That means amount received in India. No, in short, they are confusing you. See, you are living in India. You have paid me the interest because I am giving you the loan. You are paying me the interest. See, interest is coming out from outside India. Interest is accrued from outside India. No, but it is received in India. See, written there. Received from a non-resident for a loan provided to run a business in India. Therefore, the business is there in India. So, जो बिजनेस इंडिया में है ना उसको चलाने के लिए टू रन द बिजनेस इन इंडिया यू आर आई एम प्रोवाइडिंग यू I am providing you the loan, and with because I am providing you the loan, you are giving me the interest. Therefore, it is utilized in India. Okay. Therefore, this 10,000 will be categorized to all three status, taxable in all three categories. Okay. Now, is it clear?
Yes, clear?
Because that interest, I mean, that loan is utilized for running the business in India, no? Therefore, interest will also be categorized, I mean, taxable to all three categories. Very simple. Next, income from investment in Japan received also in Japan by authorized.
Sixth condition.
Yes, representative there.
First category, magazine.
Yes, sixth case. This is sixth case because nothing we have got to do with India. India se koi lena dena nahi. Income from business in India, all three categories. You have any doubt with this 80,000 income from business in India?
No, ma'am. No.
Royalty from a resident for technical services provided outside India. Have you got anything to do with India here?
No, ma'am.
See, royalty from a resident for technical services provided outside India. It is provided outside India, no? Right? It is not provided in India. Neither they say that amount is received in India. No. Because the services are provided outside India, payment is also done there because they are not disclosing. Therefore, sixth case says it is not connected with India anywhere.
Yes, ma'am.
So one case only, first category only. Past untaxed foreign income brought to India, clearly written condition. As seventh case. Clearly written as the seventh case.
Seventh case.
Neither taxable in, yes. Not taxable in either of the three categories. So get me the total.
5,08,000.
Yes.
2,48,000.
Yes.
And 2,28,000.
Okay. Has everybody got the answer?
Yes, ma'am. Right answer.
Okay. Correct. So this is the page. No, I can't minimize it. You can see, but wait. This is the page that I have given it to you for. A short revision of whole chapter. It is just a short revision. Okay. These are the basic conditions which are given for a person to become a resident. These are additional conditions which are given for a person to become resident and ordinarily resident. If not fulfilled, then person is automatically called as resident but not an ordinary resident. And these are, it is an exceptional rule. An Indian citizen leaves India. This is for leaving outside India, and this is a person of Indian origin who lives outside India but coming back to India for the purpose of visit. So these are exceptional rules. Okay, this is just a revision for you. Okay, in a tabular form, additional conditions are also given. Okay, and in the table they are telling you that apply first condition. If it is not satisfied, then apply both 2A and 2B condition. Okay. If any of the condition is satisfied, you will be called as resident. After recognizing a person as a resident, you will apply additional conditions. Of course, while applying the basic condition, you have to check with the exceptional rule also. While applying the basic condition, first, while reading the question only, you will have to check whether person falls in exceptional rule or not. Okay? Okay. Now, after you have recognized a person as an Indian resident, I mean his status as a resident status, then you will shift to the additional conditions. If both the additional conditions are satisfied, you will be called as resident and ordinarily. If either of them has not been satisfied, or both of them are not satisfied, then you will be called as resident but not an ordinary resident. And of course, the basic condition does not satisfy, you will be called as non-resident. Okay. Now this is revision. This was the revision. Upper part was residential status. The lower part is of resident scope of total income, which says Indian and global incomes are taxable. This says only Indian income and one foreign income is taxable. If it is controlled, business is controlled from India or profession is set up in India, only that global income is taxable. And non-resident says, in the case of non-resident, only and only Indian incomes are taxable. Okay. So this was just a revision and we are done with the chapter.
मैम आपने डायरेक्ट टेक्स्ट में क्लासरूम बनाए हो?
हाँ जी बिल्कुल, मतलब आप गूगल क्लासरूम पे पूछ रहे हैं?
यस मैम।
हाँ जी बिल्कुल बनाया है, आप अपने फ्रेंड्स में से किसी को पूछकर कोड ले लीजिए।
शुभम, हाँ शुभम से ले लेती
हूँ। कोड ले लीजिए और उसमें ज्वाइन कीजिए, उसमें सारे नोट्स मैंने दे रखे हैं चैप्टर वन से लेकर। ओके, एवरीथिंग इज मेड ऑलरेडी, आई एम गिविंग यू चैप्टर वाइज, जब हम चैप्टर कर रहे हैं तो मैं आपको नोट्स दे रही हूँ. So you guys don't have to ask me again and again. And also, if अगर आप recording सुनना चाहते हो तो playlist का option है, subscribe कर लो channel को और playlist का option है, in click that playlist option and you will find chapter wise recording. Residential chapter is there. Okay. Introduction chapter is there separately. Introduction of direct tax. That way. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes. So, shall we wind up? We'll continue in the next lecture. Do I have it tomorrow? I have lecture tomorrow, right? Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Do lecture.
Okay, fine. So, we will start with the another chapter. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes. Okay.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, everybody. I'll meet you tomorrow.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. You too. And please keep revising. I'll share this document in the Google Classroom. Okay. Take care, everybody. Bye.